Right. Sorry about this, guys. The late arrival of flights, as I always tell you, couldn't do anything about it. I myself just come back from Geneva. Had to rush through and pretend I did my COVID test. Came on time because I'm going to meet Siddharth Kannan, one of the legends of the audio and I would say visual industry also. But I think that would be a little bit too much. We'll stay with audio for now. He's laughing and making faces. Reminds me of my first girlfriend. Except he's got a really long nose now. Seems like something's been going on with under the knife. But first, let me rant for a second. I've decided to add one more minute to my life because it's already packed with so many different things. So I'm now spending 1 minute every day. And Siddharth, please hear this and tell me if you're doing the same. Taking out food from in between my teeth with my fingers. Okay? I just do it with my fingers because I'm old-fashioned. I can't use those things. And I can't even find that. It takes longer to do that, whatever it's called. So I just use my fingers. But it's been a revelation. I think women are treating me better. I do this every morning after my 12 eggs. And I immediately see the results. They're talking to me nicer. Everything seems better. So Siddharth Kannan, can we start by looking at your teeth, please?
Oh, look at this.
It's glorious. Wow. Yeah, it's like a fish called Wanda, but really bad
Do
version.
you like my jawline? First time, look at the jawline. Look at the cutting. Look at the cutting.
I told
I can chop an egg into two parts.
Sid, I told everyone that if I talk to Sid Kannan, it's going to be a area not treaded before. It'll be a very sophisticated and mature chat. And I got to tell you, we started the right way. From here, we can only go up.
But listen, I want to sing the Bappi Lahiri song. Will you do it with
We'll
me?
sing the Bappi Lahiri song. I will never stop you.
Lovers, night lovers,
I'm feeling it.
lovers,
I am feeling it.
night lovers. Come on, sing. Yeah, come on,
Is
Cyrus.
the third verse the same? Night lovers, lovers. Then I can go with it. Yeah, okay. Lovers, night lovers. Why are you moving around in this strangely sexual vibe? Which is. Oh my God. All right. Okay. Fair,
But
fair enough.
you are a passionate lover, whether it
I.
was a neighbor's wife, whether it was Kunal Vijayakar, whether it was Amit Doshi,
Which
you've given
is
them
the
love.
same thing. But I just want to tell you, just looking at you right now, I can see lockdown has had a profound effect. And you've regressed even by what, 3 more years now? So we are 4.5 and 7.5 as we speak. But Sid, before you spend the whole day behaving like a complete idiot, which is also good for the show, I want to just tell you we need to discuss your great rise from a ball boy in Lucknow to one of the, if not the highest paid acoustic man in India. No, let me get this right. Voiceover artist of India. Am I right?
Listen, that's a perception I try and create, but whenever I
Second
do
highest paid, Rishi's highest paid, your brother.
no, both the
Third
brothers.
highest paid, Raju Srivastava, Rishi, then you.
Okay, no,
Fourth highest paid, damn you. Make the top five,
I
please.
get four vada paus in return. So every time I do a voiceover, anytime I do anything, people pay me in vada paus. That's it.
Okay, I'll tell you what we'll do. Let's go right to the beginning. Okay, because people, there are a few people actually listen to this show and they want to know more about you. And they've already been texting in saying, why isn't he telling us about his life? So I want to take you back. At the age of 17, your very first entry into this business was with who? Tell the people. Kaisa
All right,
hua,
let
kab
me tell
hua?
you honestly.
Yeah, go on.
I started as a 14-year-old boy.
You're
I came from
14?
Lucknow. Yes.
I remember you're 17. Huh? You were already 6 foot tall.
Yeah, because I got sacked from the previous radio station and I joined your radio station.
Yeah.
Okay.
Huh.
And when I started at 14, I came from
Radio
Lucknow.
star, huh?
And I started doing a college show for a radio station called Times FM.
This is
And
in Bombay or Lucknow?
this was in
Cal. Okay.
Bombay. So I came from Lucknow. I was waiting for my college admission, which is
For the
FIT.
stop. We have to explain also. This is why he speaks Hindi like a Lucknowite or Lucknowi. And it's embarrassing because he's a Tambram by descent. But I think Hindi is almost like his main language. So I was amazed because I've grown up with a lot of South Indian friends, Mumbai being cosmopolitan. In Mumbai, nobody speaks Hindi well. Not the North Indians or the South Indians or the East Indians or anyone. And so I was amazed actually when you first spoke in Hindi and the command over the language, it was shocking, almost disgusting in some ways. And but a revelation. Now go on.
Yeah, so before that,
Well, actually,
I
what?
want
Stop talking. I'll
to
do the talking
share.
now.
I want to
I'm
share it
bored of
with
your whole
me.
fucking life story. It's going to go on and on and on and on. Okay.
Okay, listen, say Baba after every line. Wo
Baba.
gulabi kya jisme lali na ho,
Baba.
wo gulshan hi kya jisme mali na ho,
It's Wawa. I thought Baba.
wo ssurali kya
Bengali
jisme
for Wawa.
taali na
Wah,
ho,
wah. Get back to get back on track. 17,
aur wo
14, 15.
program hi kya
Let's find a
jisme
middle ground.
taali na
15
ho.
and a half, whatever the hell it was. You were doing shows for Times FM.
Yeah,
What
till
the hell?
the age of like 16, 16 and a half.
Stop. Why are you wiping your face?
Because I'm getting very emotional. Because at the age of 17, I did a show with you in Radio Star, called Char Bade Band Baje, which was probably with Cyrus a beautiful phase in my life, because I realized
I do that.
I can't go lower than this.
You started there, Baba. Baba, whatever you want. Yeah, okay. So I just want to tell everybody about our meeting. It's not like Salim Javed, but something similar, or Lennon McCartney. You came to Khar where Sanjeev Vadwani had a studio. Am I right?
Yes.
And you came 25 minutes late. This is my
memory. Remember that?
I will never forget that. Cyrus Saukar, late. What's his name? Siddharth Kanan, late. Nikhil Chinnappa, late. They've scarred me after that. It's very difficult to have a relationship. So we were waiting there. I'm jumping up and down like a hot samosa, and nobody knows where you are. But you were very sweet. And I do remember that I was irritated enough to read a book while we were talking at the same time, just to piss you off. But you handled it very nicely. You obviously had met a lot of people who are, let's just say, from left wing. No, left wing is terrible. We don't market ourselves like that. Go ahead.
So I'll tell you what, but I'll really, really, at the risk of sounding a little emotional, I think you had a big impact in my life, Cyrus. You know?
It was not a dirty touch. Come on. We're just two young guys. I was a lot older, but he's still young.
And Cyrus, in that show, whitewashed me. You know? He didn't let me say a single line. Do you know what happened after that? Let me tell you what happened.
I was reading my book. I remember Sanjeev laughing because I kept reading my book. But you were very sweet. You were not in this obnoxious loudmouth that you later became, and which made you famous and lots of money and girls. And till today, we only discuss sex, which you have and I don't. So it's very interesting how things changed. But you were very, I think, I won't tell the truth about Siddharth Kanan and upset you a little bit. You're actually deep down a very nice, decent and polite man. Parents brought you up well. So the initial thing when you were with all of us, we saw that. Later on, you decided this avatar works for you and you started bouncing off the walls and you take too much caffeine and NO2 or whatever the hell products you take and you went berserk. But the first thing is you're very, you know, Tamiz, as they say in Lucknow, in your way of presenting yourself, and almost like a schoolboy. And so much as Sanjeev was feeling really bad because I was being a little standoffish with my book. And I don't know why I carried a book. I mean, like a novel. I was reading a freaking novel for some reason.
Yeah. No, but did you read that book because you thought that I was this arrogant boy who's going to walk into the studio and didn't respect seniors, honestly?
I was fucking. You weren't arrogant at all. You're arrogant now. At that time, you were lovely. You were a lovely. I want to congratulate your parents. They have not to be faulted. I say this to a lot of people who don't understand. People change. Okay, your parents did do a good job. Charles Manson, at the age of 16, was decent. You know, he was looking at, you know, doing a road trip and helping the poor. By 17, it changed. You were 17, by the way, when you walked into my life for the first time, my love. So I'm just saying, when you came from Lucknow, Calcutta, with all the, you know, things, you were a well-brought up, middle-class boy from a good family who spoke three languages fluently, very intelligent, decently well-read, and then you decided to change and throw this all away. Dikao, sir. The nation needs to. Am I allowed to use that phrase?
Dude, you decoded me, man. You decoded me.
So what is he in Rishi, your elder brother, by the way? For anyone who doesn't know, Rishi is the other half of the Kanan twins and runs Radio Midday. What is it called now? Radio Midday. Midday Radio. Midway Radio? Radio at some point in
Paris. Radio 1, 94.3.
Radio. Yeah. I was coming to 1. It's a question of numbers. So he is what you were. He's always soft-spoken, well-behaved, well-mannered, etc. And then, of course, so don't tell us about the growth. This is not an accusation. I just want to know. So then we met, we started talking, and then you got into radio. Tell us the current story.
I got into radio, then I got into voiceovers. And then there's a guy called Baba Sehgal, you know, ice baby, thanda thanda pani. So Baba and me made a radio demo for Radio Mirchi, and the Mirchi guys loved it, and they made it into a TV show on Zoom TV. So what was essentially
right.
A radio show became a TV show.
So you were like a podcast, actually, in a sense, for the first time, which went on because you guys were chatting. It was a chat show.
Yeah. So Baba and me suddenly were brought onto television, and you know, we were doing random stuff. There were no take, retake, stuff like that. And from there, obviously, you know, I was doing radio simultaneously. Then one guy walked up to me and he said, "You know what, Siddharth, why don't you start shooting your radio interviews and putting it on YouTube?" And I was like, "Listen, man, I don't have time to do this." And after 6 months, he again came back to me, and I was the first guy who started shooting his radio interviews and putting it on YouTube. And that started taking off tremendously, you know? And from there, from a radio guy to a TV guy to a voiceover guy, I became a digital baby as well.
And you've got some 1 million, 1,000 lakh followers from what I gather.
Yeah, it's pretty good. I've crossed like 250 million views.
Because I remember how sweetly you sent me a message saying, send me congratulations, I've just crossed 1 million or 2 million or whatever. I always appreciate it. It's like someone saying, this is my birthday today, please wish me. I just love that.
No, but doesn't everyone do that, sir? Say, listen, I want an ID. I want an ID which says mine is the best chat show. You've done that too. Have you done that or not?
Okay, listen, we have lots to talk about. I have. I want to get into you. We're skipping events. Bro, you're a one-man industry. I think in lockdown, because whatever offers I get also, Siddharth Kananvi Kara and all that, you're one of the few people who got work through lockdown. You work across North, South, East and West India. And I think in the last 4 or 5 years, I think you've been traveling well, before this lockdown crap happened, because you yourself told me that, you know, I don't even know where my wife is anymore. I've got pictures of my family. Rishi, is it with a K? Is it with an H? You know, because you just won't want home because of the demand for Siddharth Kanan. Everybody wants Siddharth Kanan, who gives them everything on at an event. I mean, first, sex appeal. Secondly, you know, you can talk about anything with anyone. And thirdly, a little bit of comedy, a little bit of gravitas, you know, good looking. Did I mention that? Yes, I did. So yeah, tell us about the event thing, because I would say you're one of the top five guys in the event business in terms of the kind of business you generate and in black money and taxes that you don't pay.
Let me tell you one thing, yeah. Okay? So major part of my revenue comes from live gigs, primarily because I speak
like
about
this one, we're paying you.
Yeah,
wink,
right.
Wink.
Giving me a vada pav for this also.
Wow, wow. Whatever you want.
But I'll be honest, all right? In April, when this whole lockdown thing happened, I was like, God, I am screwed because, you know, 70% of my revenue comes from live gigs. Then my team and I sat April and May and just worked up interactive gags for the virtual platform. And I somewhere had this instinct that this is going to happen virtually. And in May, I actually started calling people and saying, you know what? I've got these ideas. Let me do demos for you. And I started doing demos for brands entire May with all the interactive gags that I had done for virtual events that I had ideated. And from July onwards, it just started kicking off. And today, I don't have time to breathe with events also. So April, May, because I was devastated inside, I actually used that for myself and started creating these gags, which worked virtually as well. So sometimes when I'm under pressure and I feel I'm screwed in life, I think I function better. And I'm very driven, Cyrus. I'm very driven. You know what I mean?
You don't have to tell me. That's what I've been telling everybody, this whole act. It's not really an act. That's part of your personality. I'll give you 10% for that. The loudness and all is just one side. It's a very hardcore business mind, sort of, you know, very wired and focused person, which I saw that very first day when you tried to make up for your lateness. By the way, why the fuck were you late, Siddharth? I mean, I know we shouldn't bring it up. It's like bad blood after the 40 years or what?
You know, can I tell you honestly? So I was going to take a rickshaw and come because my parents were down. They moved to Chennai after we were in Bombay. They moved to Chennai. I didn't want to move to Chennai because I wanted to make a career in entertainment. So I wanted to take a rickshaw and come to you. And I realized it would cost me like $120 from Andheri West.
And I'm not Madhuri Dixit. I'm giving a reference from that time. So it makes sense you don't spend $120 to come to meet me. Go ahead.
And then a sudden friend of mine told me that, listen, hold on. Give me 10 minutes more. I'll take you in my car. So to save $120, I waited for my friend. I got into his car and I came to meet you.
Horrible stories. Lack of respect for the aging seniors waiting for you in a studio. Sanjeev Advani put the AC off because you were late. He said, we'll put it on once he comes in. That alone infuriated me. Because the first 5 minutes I was fine. And then 5 minutes later, I was sweating buckets in a small place, converted room into a studio. Those were the days. Okay,
listen. Yeah. But by the way, let me make a confession. After you whitewashed me in my first show, I called up the radio star head. I called him up. And I said, listen, you want me to do a show with this guy? And he didn't let me say a line. He whitewashed me. So he said, listen, he must be pissed with you. But I said, listen, what if he comes again and he's pissed with me again for some reason? And I said, I'm sorry, I was late. So he said, no, you know, Cyrus is a really nice guy. And you just hang in there and then he'll give you a chance to talk. But do you know what I did after that? For my second episode,
yeah,
I actually came up with lines where I said, if I say this and Cyrus says this, what are the 5 alternatives?
Wow, okay. You work so hard on a fuck all craft. I'm so impressed.
So in those days, so I was like, if I say this and Cyrus is going to give me 5 repartees, this could be the 6th one. What a repartee.
Sid Kanan exposed again. See, you try to act like this crazy guy, but deep down, this is the look at the work you put in. You're the Aamir Khan of radio.
You're
the one of 32 rehearsals. Now let's come to our drinking story. Oh, sorry. Do you want to complete that story? Because usually
I
interrupt it.
So then I came with 6 options of everything you would say. And do you know what? I you walked in and you were, again, as usual, your witty self. And then I dropped my guards down. And I said, listen, this guy's not going to screw me over. And that's it. I just kept that paper in my pocket only. And I went for it the way I would.
And then we embraced and we made love. And the world changed.
Left.
I thought we had good chemistry, you know, all said and done. I enjoyed all the shows. And I know Kunal couldn't take it because once we had him over, and because it just became too much. It was like two children misbehaving in the class. And he was like completely like, well, I can't do this anymore.
You want to tell people what we used to watch while recording our radio shows?
It's one of my favorite stories, especially people who are nervous doing these things. I tell them because they really, I'm not saying you belittle what you're doing, but it's really, sometimes it's just not rocket science. People have to understand that. I mean, presenting five songs, I mean, the two lines of information about them. So Sid Kanan and I, to kill time, late mornings at radio. Can I say the name?
Might
come after us. Let's say it rhymes with Kirchi. Radio, it rhymes with Kirchi. And out of sheer boredom. And Claver. Claver is part of this. I hope he's still there, because that'll be a problem. So Claver is not part of this in that case, in case he still has a job. If he's off the job, then he's part of this. That's the way we put it. Claver was a sound engineer, guitarist, musician, lovely guy, and aficionado of erotic literature and cinema. So that's what we would do. We'd put on the old goldies, oldies, but not the... How do I explain it? I'll let you do it.
Okay, so listen.
Because it was always your selection, by the way.
So those were VCR days. You put VCR
cassette. You say cassette, yeah.
Huh. Okay, cassettes. Huh. Cyrus and me used to record links and we used to watch adult movies. And Cyrus loved animal films. So it had to do a lot with animals. And we used to watch it and record. And at one point of time, Kunal didn't know what we were watching inside. And Mr. Vijaykar walks in and he's like, I want to watch too. So we
That's
got...
That's a perfect... I would say best impression of Kunal I've ever seen. Yeah, go on.
So at the end of the day, we would watch about 2-3 films, which are like 10 minutes because there were not much of a storyline. The films would get over easily. And in a span of an hour, we would watch 3 adult movies. And
we talk about it, didn't we? Like while, you know, we talk about the scene and all that. Remember
yeah,
that?
Yeah, we would actually talk. We would say, you know what? There's an animal coming. I love animals. And you know what? The dog is walking towards the horse. And there's this intelligent man who's coming. And we'll just talk about it. And then suddenly our recording would be over. Our, you know, movies would be over. And this we would do religiously all the time. And I still remember your landline number because I was the producer on the show.
Oh, my God.
And I used to call him on that landline number. You didn't have a mobile. Now you
and
have
I had
a mobile.
To come to Mahim, right? We record a lot at Mahim also later on.
Absolutely. And we used to have a thing called Old Monk sometimes.
Well, that's also another name for me in the old days. Yeah, so that's a true story. And we discuss it. And our contract was renewed because obviously it was very good, the discussions. Then let's move on to your drinking story, Siddharth. When you started misbehaving and chasing the ladies, can I tell them about the girls you've been with and had relations with and fun with? I shouldn't do that, right? That wouldn't be right.
No, listen. I have a story for you. So I was dating this really nice girl. And I told her that, listen, there's a party in Pedder Road. And, you know, Cyrus and Kunal, would you like to go for this party? And both of you said, yes. I said, listen, I can't go for it, but you take my girlfriend for it. So both of you came to Bandra to fetch her, like good boys. And then you took her to that Pedder Road party. And at 3 a.m., she calls me in the landline saying, you know what? Both of them are smashed. They don't know what the hell they're doing. What am I supposed to do? Because I've come in their car and, you know, I have to take care of them. So, you know what I told her? I said, just leave them there, take a cab and come back.
What happened to us?
As usual, we were lying down on the ground, making love to each other, caressing
okay.
each
so
other.
So, I'll tell you what. No, you're fair enough. But I'll tell you, I want to give the devil his due and I'm going to be open and honest because I believe you stand up and take your blows and accept, you know, your faith sometimes if you've had some karma which is not good before. This was entirely and completely Kunal's fault. All right? It was completely his fault because he suddenly, if I remember right, got really upset, wanted to eat food. He used to do this while drinking. We had these gears. So we'd get like really up. And then at some point, he'd just be really hungry and want to leave. And then start behaving like a spoiled kid. So I think that's what really happened. We may have abandoned her. Not really remembering that we had to bring her back. This has happened a few times. But it's too much. How the hell did we come to Bandra to fetch her and all? I can't believe, I mean, how desperate were we? And that too for your girlfriend to have a good time.
No, but maybe you guys were never invited to a party. Maybe
that's it.
The first
that's
time.
It. You need a female. They always say couples only. And when I push him in front of me, you know, and try to make him look like which he does now, look like a really middle-aged housewife. But sadly, that didn't work then. Yeah. But Sid, we've had some good times, great memories. I'm ashamed of 95% of them, but there have been a few good ones. Meet you at the airport is always good to pass time at 5:30 in the morning, somewhere in, say, Calicut airport, waiting to board a plane, those kind of things.
And both of us exchanging notes on the mobile, looking at photographs.
No, you took Ivan, my makeup man, I remember, took him aside and showed him porn at 5:30 in the morning. He's not very fair. He came back pale. He was like, oh, kya kya dikhaya mereko? And I was like, Ivan, this is Siddharth. This is his collection. This is what he does for society. You know, this is all before Me Too. By the way, how did you escape that net, bro?
Yeah, brother. You know what? I've just shifted to the other side. That's all.
So you're the one who's getting molested, is that it? Okay, we'll take a quick break. We'll come back a little bit more with Siddharth, and then we'll include Silvery, a stand-up comedian who grew up listening to Sid Kannan and is his number one fan in Pawai, that lane that joins Hiranandani A to B, that, well, not even that full, somewhere in that garden area. We'll come back. Break. Sid, we're back. That's our break.
What are you saying?
Yeah, got you. The fastest break in the West, bro. Fastest break in the West. Have you ever seen that? Ever?
God.
It's my favorite thing. I don't know why we take the break. Nobody's explained it to me. We just do it out of habit. You know, years and years on TV, you just have to say break. It's like that for some reason. If you don't say it, you're out.
But listen, do people at times call you uncle also or not? I really want to know.
Uncle happened long ago. I'm over that complex. Uncle, the worst moment, Oval Maidan, I remember the year also. It was 1998. 98, 99. I was about 26, 25, somewhere there when the first uncle happened. So once that first uncle is the painful one. So kids were playing cricket and the ball rolled towards me. I was with my dog and the guy goes, hey, uncle, ball dena. And I picked up the ball. He was about 10 years old. I threw it like, you know, a couple of days from deep square leg. Again, my reference, my age group. Hit him on the head and it bounced to the other guy who caught it. And he was looking at me, holding his head, very perplexed. And I was like, oh, sorry, but I was so happy inside because he said, uncle, you... So that terrible moment, but it took some time. You feel bad, you introspect, you wonder about your hair, is any gray, this, that, and the other. It was a period. But now what, uncle? Now I'm how old am I?
I've also started feeling like that, man. When I meet 16, 17-year-olds, I have a very paternal feeling.
Why are you with 16, 17-year-olds? You do a radio show, for fuck's sake. What are you doing?
We meet a lot of 16, 17-year-olds in events.
Why?
Backstage.
What are you interviewing people for college? What the hell are you doing?
No, but you know, people who hang around you, right?
No, it's sounding very creepy. I want the honest truth here. Sid, what's going on? Because you're always on that line. I feared for you. Mine would, you know, alcohol-fueled misbehavior. But yours was from early morning flights. Ivan, you made him watch what one of the oldest porn, the Dirty Cowboy collection, I remember. And Ivan wanted to understand because he liked the plot, actually. He didn't so much.
But listen,
like the sex.
Listen. I want to tell you, can I say this? Kunal Vijayakar had a big crush on Parizad Zorabian. You know that, right?
I think maybe. I can't remember.
And he's had
but he's had crushes on every single girl, you know, for a few minutes at least, until he realizes he'll have to get up and actually talk.
He told me he was very emotional about her. And you made it into a joke. You didn't give Kunal the courage to kind of pour his heart out to Parizad.
I don't feel that it's right that any female should have the attention of Kunal. He's over suffocating, comes too close, breaks all codes of proximity, is... The female instinct in him is too strong for me. You know, in the sense that he's maternal, lovey-dovey, cuddly-wuddly. So I see him more like a stuffed toy who can be borrowed by people for a few minutes and returned to the department store. I don't think that any woman should be stuck with him for a long period of time. Honestly speaking, he's a very needy man. Now that you brought it out, let's just discuss Kunal for 5 minutes. Five best qualities of Kunal Vijayakar. Picture to be shown at some point. I hope we can locate it. My producer Silvery has gone to sleep. But what do you like about this noted celebrity?
Kunal, when he keeps his mouth shut, sounds very intelligent.
Nice. Good. Did he ever upset you? Like our first introduction, did he ever? Because he's got a short temper.
No, I've never seen that. No, but I always honestly had a very grandfather-grandson feeling. That kind of a bond with him, you know? Yeah, I would always say like, Kunal ji, kaise hain aap ji, you know?
Right.
Pai lagu ji, you know?
I wouldn't go that far. But I do remember, I mean, our drinking sessions, you and I would be on another tangent and he would always be a little behind that, which is good. You need the third guy to be holding back a little bit so that someone, we used to drive and do not drink and drive. In the 90s, unfortunately, we did drink and drive. Sid and I both, but we made Kunal drive because he used to drink a little less, as far as I remember. Yeah. So he played his part. And I also, for me, it's all the theory of relativity, which is that you, me, him together, then out of these three, who's the best looking? Hence, the girl would probably, you know, you see our chances, with due respect, go up a little bit, right, Sid?
Yeah. But, you know, Kunal deep down has a sex appeal.
Very deep down.
Yeah, he always appeals to sex. He always appeals to sex. Oh,
so I killed your gag. I'm so sorry. Set up gag. You have to send me a message. I'm setting up a gag. This is an improv conversation. That's the whole podcast style. When we have to set up gags, we get screwed. The poor guy's waiting to deliver his punch, and here I go. 92 doesn't. No point to that. Oh, man. Okay, before anybody else coming in the podcast, you've got to set up gag. You have to warn us so we can give you your space. Yeah, this is Sid at his best. Yeah. But some good memories, Sid. And then how did you bloody get married? You, the eternal bachelor, chasing every skirt in sight, misbehaving all the time, only talking about women with me, which thank God you did that, because at some point the world changed and we weren't allowed to talk about anything. But how do you get married? Very quickly, because you need to get Silvery in.
You know, okay. By the way, I had an arranged marriage. All right. And can I tell you, honestly...
Is there a punch?
No, there's no
quiet. No, there's no punch.
It's very, very heart to heart. It's like very honest for the first time. So I actually bought my own house when I was like 22 years old. All right. Yeah. And I stayed in that house, which is like a 4 BHK. And I started coming home and I said, God, I needed people around me all the time.
Really?
I needed people around me all the time.
Come in the camera. This is Ivan, guys. Sorry to interrupt. This is Ivan. Ivan, do you remember what you saw airport? Which picture? Do you remember it or not? Tell me. Gandhi Gandhi picture, right? Who was it? Ilzam lagao. Who was it? Point to the bugger. Right? Siddharth? Kanan.
Irvin, ye le puppy.
Yeah. No. Let him work. Someone has to work in this studio. Carry on, sir. 22, you got your own house. I interrupted your flow.
Then... when I started coming to my house, I was like, damn, I needed people around me all the time. So, you know what I told my mom? I said, every time I get into a relationship, you know, there's a breakup that happens and, you know, blah, blah, blah. You know, I get hurt, X, Y, Z. And I actually told my mom that, listen, find me a girl. And she's like, you're sure? So she went to a friend's wedding. She saw my would-be wife. We exchanged emails. We spoke on the phone. I went to Chennai. She came to Bombay. And within 3 months, we were engaged, 6 months married. Now 2 kids, father to a 5-year-old daughter and 2-year-old daughter. Wow.
Wow. Oh, so now you've changed because you're surrounded by women. You don't have a choice. You go, what karma? I love this.
No, but I'll tell you what's happened. Okay, there's So whenever I, Maros, like, you know what, right now when I'm talking to you, and I talk about those days when we watch those obnoxious films, suddenly I start seeing my daughter's face in front of me and I'm like, oh my God, behave.
Why didn't we discuss this before we started talking, you moron? they'll be on your podcast like this. What's wrong with you, man? It stays for posterity. All the good-looking ones we keep. Yeah.
Yeah, so then, I mean, I was the last guy who'd get into an arranged marriage. But thankfully, I've got a girl who's pretty solid, man.
All right, bro. I'm going to have to cut your flow here for a second. Love to talk to you longer because there's so many things are coming in my head, but we can't mention them all at one go. But we do have Silvery and Amit who will join us now and we'll go into the AMAs. And maybe Silvery will tell you about how he feels about growing up with Siddharth Karan's voice in the background. I mean, whether it's getting up in the morning, sitting on the pot, right?
Silvery.
To the end, going to bed.
But why is he called Silvery?
Oh, no, don't ask that. We'll put a disclaimer somewhere explaining that. Can't put Silvery all the time.
But he's a bearded guy. I thought it was a lady.
Yeah. But there are bearded ladies. It's Kunal's last act. Remember, finally, when there's nothing else going, Kunal's going to have a beard, become female, and we're going to go.
Did you tell Silvery that whenever I start a conversation, I want a kiss?
Okay. He just mentioned his two daughters. He just mentioned how he's changed. He just mentioned how his lovely daughter's pure face is above his head, looking down like God at him. And then he goes and does this. This is Siddharth Karan.
Silvery, I want a kiss.
Silvery, give him a kiss. Get it over with.
No.
What are you, friends? It's not Silvery. It's in your Silvery.
Okay. Silvery, give me 3 versions of a kiss.
Okay. Really?
Yeah, never been asked this before. This is a normal question. Passerbys ask us this all the time. Go on.
Yeah, normally it's like just a one kiss and then never see me again because that's what most of my dates are like. But
is that a setup gag? I hate these setup gags. No setup gags on this show. Yeah.
Okay. I don't know what to do. Like, I'm not going to...
Piss fast. Hurry it up. hey, what was that dunk crap for, man? Oh, there goes the sponsor. One bloody Siddharth Karan, you're off this show. This is ridiculous.
But tell me, Silvery, have you genuine? What was this? I really want to know.
Yeah, what was that?
That's That's I don't know.
Do you want Ivan to do
French kiss? That's hoping for a French kiss. That's what.
But yeah, I think Amit can do a better job than that.
Oh, God. Yeah, if you get Amit on kiss, I will send you 5 lakhs in check right now. I'm writing down the check. You get Amit to behave like that. Check's ready.
Yeah, no, that's very unlikely that would happen.
But Cyrus, I've been told that, you know, somewhere I read an article, and obviously you paid for the article.
Of course.
You know how media is being bought nowadays.
100%. That's the way to go forward in an educated society. Yes.
Yeah. So they said, you know, Cyrus has stopped drinking and he's become lean and, you know, he's got a V-shaped body. What does a V-shaped body mean?
You go do a headstand, put your legs wide like that. Yesterday we had a guest doing the same thing and it's V-shaped. Don't worry about it. Don't take all that seriously. It's very scary when people start believing their own myth. When people start calling me up and saying, can you give us advice for fitness? I say, please fuck off. Leave me alone. It's just something I do in my side business. Yeah. Like, my core business is a podcast. Siddharth Kannan's 1 million, 2 million. How many followers?
Now listen, tell me. But
I need your followers. Send us your followers.
Listen.
Tell your followers to follow.
Listen, okay, follow him. Anyways, everyone follows him. But listen, you did have performance anxiety, Cyrus.
Oh, yes, I did. The first time you asked me to kiss 3 times. The whole 3-time business. What's with you in threes? It's a Lucknow thing. And you have to do everything in threes. It's too much for people like me. We struggle with the one.
All right, Silvery, you got to say something very intellectual to us.
Yeah, ask the questions, dude.
Okay, yes. All right, some intellectual questions coming your way. First one comes in from Rohit Pillai. This is cricket related. He says,
Siddharth, are you a cricket guy, Siddharth?
Yeah, I watch a lot of cricket. Yes.
Siddharth is a normal guy. Amit, the guys who don't watch cricket are the normal guys. One is sitting in front of me with a long wig and mustache right now. So let me tell you, there's a minority there. Huh. Go on.
All right. Rohit Pillai asks, Cyrus and guest, now that England series is happening on home turf after an amazing Australia series, would you go and watch the match live if it's open to public?
Well, like Chennai, it's not open. Ahmedabad, it's probably not open. But they're saying the T20s and the One Dayers in Ahmedabad and Pune, those they'll be allowing some. They're pushing for that. Would you go, Sid?
I would love to go, man. I'd love to go to the stadium and watch.
It depends on the heat. So if the weather is okay, because I after that Oval, England, Surrey Oval experience in 2017, Champions Trophy, where I suddenly landed up there, like I told you guys 200 times, and it was really sunny and I'm sweating and the Indians and Pakistanis shouting, Zindabad, Zindabad. I'm like, I paid money, I'm in London, I'm in Oval, and all I have is Indians and Pakistanis screaming at each other.
But I like sweat. I like sweat. I like it.
Yeah, but you got your three kiss shit going on. No? So you've got people to talk to. What do? I don't want the three kiss thing with every Tom, Dick and Raju.
But you know what? If I sweat while watching a match, yeah. I feel I'm there. I feel I'm one of the cricketers, man. Otherwise, you feel you're watching a fashion show in a 5-star hotel, which I'm never allowed in.
Well, in the IPL, you can confuse one for the other sometimes, especially in the older days.
Okay, listen, I want to ask you, when you watch the IPL and you hear these sound effects, right, of people clapping.
And the footy.
Yeah, the
you follow
audio.
Footy as well, yeah.
In all of sports, right? Even the NBA, they have the crowd noises.
So we discussed this. Initially, it was a bit of a headache because you can sort of see that it's not always the timing is a little off. It's a bit like my jokes. It doesn't match sometimes. However, I've got used to it now because I've been watching the entire India-Australia series early.
Also, I think they've gotten better at it, right? I mean, like, it's not as obnoxious and I
tried to tell Sid that in the beginning, Amit. Just tone it down a bit. Like, it's curtail. This is the potty, you know. Nobody listens. But now they got it right. Hey, bro, what's with the hair now? What have you done?
You like my hair?
This is a new one.
Yeah, this is a new one.
Okay, we won't discuss it. Leave it.
No, but this is nice. It's easily done. It's like you got to give 2 hours a week and you're sorted, man.
2 hours a week for that?
Yeah, that's it.
I'll get you a guy who does it. I'll get you a guy who does it in 20 minutes. Okay. All right.
Okay, Silvery, go for it, baby.
Amit, yes. You don't have next to follow,
one.
Huh? Go on.
Next two questions are kind of similar, so I'm going to ask them together. First one comes in from Akshay K. He says, today is Jose's birthday. Any special message from Cyrus and Siddharth? And the second one comes from Parag Dev.
Fuck off comes to mind, quite frankly, because when we tried to contact him, he just didn't come on the line all those so many years ago. So I would say that.
But I think that Jose is like kind of renowned for that, isn't he? That like he's like notoriously hard to get on like the phone for things.
Yeah, I think there's some misunderstanding where he thought he was working with RAW. It's not clear. And so he has to keep a very invisible presence. But that's not exactly the case when he orders on Amazon, all those dildos and stuffed toys and all come to his house every week. And then suddenly he's available. And
no, but I'm exactly the opposite, you know.
Go ahead.
You just message me once that you're going to offer me 2 rupees, 5 rupees. I will come on the phone. I'll come and give you a lap dance. Tell me anything related to money. I'll pick up the phone 3 times over. Again, 3.
Well, you know, like I told the guest yesterday, this business has been known. You're not the first one to pioneer it, so don't worry. It's been there, it'll be there. So good to know. But happy birthday, Jose. Why I have bad feelings? He's a sweet guy. And
oh, no, he's a really nice guy.
Awfully strange looking.
There are other ways, right? Like, so I mean, like, he's hard to get in touch with if you try to call him, but on Twitter he'll respond to you immediately.
Yeah, but then you have to abuse him.
Huh?
To get the response. I don't feel like abusing Jose because I can't spell it one way and speak the other way. That drives me nuts.
I want to say something. I want to say something to Jose in Tamil because he understands Tamil. Cyrus,
who says he understands Tamil?
Yeah, he does. Everyone does.
Okay. After the agitation, we're starting the Tamil problem. Go ahead.
Yen vai, tani vai. Now, do you know what it means, Selvi? It means mera rasta, akela rasta, which means my way is the only way. And that is...
Is it Rajini dialogue?
Rajini dialogue, which is Jose's philosophy. My way.
Rajini dialogue, show some respect, Silvery. Kiss him 3 times. Every time you like anything Siddharth does going forward, if he's on stage, if he's on TV, or if he's on the internet, you kiss 3 people around you immediately in different ways. Right, Sid?
No, but have you ever kissed with a sound like this, Silvery?
This is our national call.
No.
What are you saying? How dare you? That's the mating call of Indian men. We do it all the time, bro. This is I'm very proud of that. I call felt, Europeans and show that to them, and they're like, wow, we've seen something artistic, you know, or culturally.
Whenever I would take a local train to reach Cyrus, sometimes.
What?
And what
local train comes to Malabar Hill? Who the hell is he saying?
Nose up in the air, cloudy. People went to do this in the train to me. When I used to get out of the train, I had a swag. I had a superiority complex because I felt so wanted when people used to. Like that.
Yeah, well,
I felt like throwing my clothes and walking naked on that railway station because when people did this, I felt I was so hot.
Really, but it goes further actually. It has gears again to it. So first is, and then there's a touching the self in that area and doing. When you actually touch and do it, you can feel more, you know, vibe there. And they actually do that. It's amazing.
But you know, I'm not kidding you. There was one guy, remember, who actually did and did like this. Like he put his fingers on his face. I want to know, was he covering his face because he didn't want to see me? Or was he covering his face because he was imagining things?
Per se, that guy was Jose, and today is his birthday. So I don't want to disrespect him. He's a sweet guy, and I want to show him some love. He married a girl from MTV, and he called me to the wedding, by the way. But it was in the suburbs. But I wished him well.
Okay, Silvery, you have
quick. I've got to shoot, yep. Guys. Come on, fast.
Yeah, okay. Quickly, this one quick comment. Gandhar Parki says, hey, Cyrus, can you ask Suresh Raina some cricket-related questions as well?
Suresh Raina?
Siddharth Kanan is saying looks like Suresh Raina a bit.
Okay.
I kind of see it. Yeah, I kind of see it.
Little bit, yeah. Okay. Yeah, the nose is a similarity. Yeah. Okay. So have you ever been mistaken for Suresh Raina?
No, I haven't. I have been... mistaken for Manoj Bajpayee, man. A lot of people say that Manoj Bajpayee looks like me. A lot of people
there is say... a similarity which yeah, I have not.
But Manoj Bajpayee, even in Vasipur or whatever, would never do. Got a lot of class about him, I tell you. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Next quick one. This one comes from Vivek Barthwal. He says, guys, what are your favorite plots in porn? If given a chance, which category would you be a part of?
In porn.
I've been in a whole chapter. I mean, I can't do this in 5 minutes, but I love bad acting in porn. And I can actually watch that and you can stop the porn because that's a separate genre for me. So I love pizza delivery guy coming and going, pizza. And then the girl saying, oh. And then she's lying on a bed and taking off her clothes while he's delivering the pizza, which makes no sense of connection. And then she says, will you join me? And you know, I mean, like, wow. And there's a young boy thinking, when will this happen to me? Yeah. And your delivery guy is this guy comes in smelling and stinking. Yeah. Hey, pizza. The whole vibe is so different when you change cultures.
But you know what? I saw a porn, which is a Hindi porn, all right?
You worked in two?
Yeah, no, I mean, I watched it. You know, I like watching a lot. You know, like that's a kink in me. I like watching. And I remember this guy met a woman who was like 20 years older than him. It was that whole mama thingy. And then he goes and says, mujhe chahiye.
Oh, you're talking about Hindi dubbing the language? Oh, that's great.
Yeah, mujhe chahiye. Like, I want, mujhe chahiye. Yeah. Tell me, Silvery, since you're heavily into this, if you watch Indian porn and a guy comes and says, mujhe chahiye, which means I want, Would you get turned on watching a porn like this?
Yeah, immediately. I would go and
add. When the male says, "Mujhe chahiye," you're turned on. Now this is just strange dynamic at play. Go on, please.
Silvery, there is
okay, a shoot cancelled. I got to understand. Yeah.
There is a potential of you being a porn star too. Can you just say "Mujhe chahiye" once in a seductive manner, please?
I mean, it's not that last thing that from the bad Hindi villain, the Shakti Kapoor. It's not that school of acting. Huh? It's more like he's almost trying to be charming in his way. So remember that. That's your focus. Now go.
Okay, Silvery, try. I think you can
crack action,
it. It's a big market. Come on,
Silvery, do it, boy.
Mujhe chahiye.
That was horrible.
Hey, man.
That's so horrible.
Why?
Don't
judge
my technique. No. Mujhe long pause. What do you? I mean, like, God. Which woman Amitabh is going to think?
Yeah.
Amitabh Singh?
Yeah.
Silvery, you know what Silvery is going to be? He's going to be the bathroom mat on which the guy and the girl out and stand on you. You're the man.
I'm thinking we've screwed him for life because his career as a porn star is going to stay in his head. He can't get through the first line of dialogue. Yeah. Forget the sex. He'll be like, Mujhe.
Silvery, I gave you a chance and you messed it up, brother.
Hey, guys, I got to go. It's really late.
I would say I aced it.
We'll see. Say, Silvery coming soon and don't spell that. Okay. Sid, I've got to go, Baba. You talk too much, wasting my time. Another boring day in my life. Thanks so much. Bye, guys. We'll see you soon. Sideways says, check out Sid Kanan on the YouTube channel called
Listen.
Hey, what about our show? Please plug our show first.
Okay, listen to me quickly. I'm starting a chat show with people from different walks of life, Bollywood stars, candid, real, unleashed. It's called Candid Kanan, and it's already been launched last week. It's going to be an IBM podcast, Spotify, and all the other platforms. But most importantly, it's an IBM podcast, Candid Kanan, chat show, Pratik Gandhi, Varun Dhawan, Anil Kapoor, Bhumi Pednekar, the works, everyone's
head. We've run out of time. Just say, Mujhe chahiye. Say, Mujhe chahiye. Oh, I'm going to edit all this. Mujhe chahiye. Okay, one time, teach the world.
Okay, look at this.
One, two, three.
Once in a blue moon, Mujhe chahiye.
How could she marry you? How could she marry you? I mean, how could they actually go through the whole? I mean, okay, bye. This is too much.
Okay, last. Do you know Ranjit? There used to be a yesterday.
Of course. Come on, fast.
Villain.
Yeah.
You know, whenever he had an action-packed scene, he would always do like this and say, "Once in a blue moon." So whenever he did this, means he's going to get action.
And are you going to get action, sweetie?
No.
Illa.
Silvery is very, very.
Chal, don't worry. When it comes to sex, all have said no. So we can say that in every language. See you guys. Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye, Silvery. Bye, Amit.
Bye.